All right, so my name is Alex ZONGO. I'm from Burkina Faso, and I'm currently studying at Tsinghua University in a master's degree in control science and engineering. But prior to that, I was actually at Beihang University, where I studied aerospace engineering, and then upon graduation, I came into Tsinghua University for my master. Obviously, like many others, it's for a scholarship. I was granted a scholarship, so I came into China in 2018. I actually transferred from another university to continue my degree, my bachelor degree in aeronautical engineering, like I said before. And then I spent like 3 years at Beihang University, and upon which graduation, I came into Tsinghua University to continue my studies. So basically, I chose China because of the scholarship, and then because I wanted also, let's say like that, to explore the culture and learn a little bit more about the language, which I speak a little, and also explore like how China has grown and to the country like we see today. When we talk about education here, I must say that in China, the education is quite similar to our countries in Africa. Let me explain that, why I'm saying that. I'm talking about actually the high school part, because coming here, you notice that the knowledge we learn actually in our countries is actually valuable in terms of the intensity in the training that we had. I'm thankful for that, because when I came here, I was actually comfortable with learning and keeping the pace with other Chinese students. In terms of higher education, like universities and stuff, I would say that Chinese education is quite intense in terms of requirements, in terms of research you have to do, and in terms of what they're expecting you to do in your homework, in your exams and stuff, in your even projects. It's like it's also project based. You're not studying like to study to learn the literature, but also you're applying what you learn as a skill in projects. That's what they actually emphasize on. So basically, my research is about using artificial intelligence, particularly the reinforcement learning technique applied in flight control. So the idea here is to make the reinforcement learning method more robust and adaptive to fault tolerance, to failure in aircraft systems. So my research actually focuses on the trade-off between tracking performances and action smoothness, so that the control is more efficient, energy efficient, the comfort of passengers is improved, and most likely the performance of the whole aircraft system also is improved. So I believe that artificial intelligence can be applied to anything in our society, any aspect, any domain in the society, especially in aviation, where we see more and more actually applications attributed to artificial intelligence. So I believe that this research is quite valuable in that regard. All right, so yeah, we all know that Tsinghua is one of the best universities in China. I would say top 1 or 2 in China, and within the top 15 in the world. So I would say the pressure is quite there. I feel the pressure every time, but I feel also proud, because it's not everybody that comes to Tsinghua. If you ask every Chinese, like, do you want to come to Tsinghua, they will actually react in a certain way, so that you see that it's quite some prestigious university to be in. So I'm learning a lot here, both from professors, from alumni, or from my peer classmates or teammates or lab mates. And the pressure is there. Although the pressure is there, I feel like the growth also, we grow actually from pressure. So yeah, it's quite eventful, the life here at Tsinghua University. There are so many activities, so many things you have to consider when you're on campus. So many things, you cannot do all of them at the same time. So you have to choose some and enjoy the life here. In terms of studies, yeah, it's intense. You have pressure from the professors, from your supervisors, or even from the administrations sometimes. So I will invite other people also to apply to Tsinghua University and come here, because right now I'm the only from my country here studying at this time. So I hope that there will be more and more people from Burkina Faso coming here and representing the country as well. AI in our countries reminds me of something like a conference I'm attending right now called IndabaX. I actually like the idea of applying AI in our society, so that conference comes at the right time. So I believe that AI can be quite a key in our socio-economic development, not only in technology in our country, but also to help the society to grow as well. So there are many domains in our countries when AI can be applied. I'm studying aviation, so I know that AI can be applied there, but other area like economy, like agriculture, or even every businesses companies in general can have some kind of artificial intelligence added to their framework or their way of doing things. So especially in our current situation in Burkina Faso, where we face difficulty in terms of assuring the defense of the security of the population, I believe that AI can also be used in many ways, like in drones, for instance, or in surveillances, like using those face detection in cameras and stuff. That's also one idea that is quite interesting to explore in that regard. I would say that since I came into China, my social life has been a little bit complex for a while because of COVID. Even before COVID, it was, I would say, good, but COVID came and then we had to be confined and so on. But I would say that my social life is quite good. I have many friends, especially on campus, Chinese, both Chinese and international friends, and we're doing fun stuff, activities, especially like hobbies, like playing sport. Let's talk about sport. For instance, I'm actually part of my department handball team. Handball is a sport that I like, so we actually participate in competitions. Although we didn't win this year, we won last year. So, and other stuff I'm doing, like I'm playing the piano, I'm playing the keyboard in a band on campus, so we're enjoying life on campus. First of all, let's talk about what I don't like, and then I will talk about what I like next. So the weather, like, it's quite cold, and then the weather is not it's fluctuating too much, because currently it's supposed to be hot, but look at what I'm wearing, like it's quite freezing outside because of the wind and stuff. So I don't like the weather, like, because it's fluctuating, and I'm coming from a country where it's quite hot, like we don't actually get used to those kind of harsh weather. Apart from that, I like the food, which first of all I didn't like at my first time, but now I'm getting used to the food and I like the food because it's quite healthy. And then, and yeah, so what I like also about China would be the technology. I like the technology. Yeah, I miss my country so much because it's been like 4 years now since I went back home in 2019, just before COVID-19. And what I miss mostly for my country, it's obviously my family, my friends, and especially the food. Yeah, because I've tried to cook before, but now I can't because of the time, and I have a tight schedule, so I cannot cook anymore. So I miss mostly the food and the environment, the family, you know, the feeling you have when you're around the people you love. So I miss that much about my country right now. Well, I would say that as an advice for someone who wants to study outside of his country, first of all, I would say he has to consider the language that they speak. I mean, mostly everywhere we speak English, so I would suggest that that person learn first English, and particularly if you want to come in China, then a must learn is English first, because when you come here, you don't know any single word in Chinese, then English is quite useful, and then afterwards you learn Chinese in English. So you have to learn English first and then learn Chinese. So once you learn Chinese, the basic stuff, you can actually live freely, like do every basic, I mean, your basic needs will be fulfilled. Apart from that, in terms of academic, I would say that first of all, be sure of what you want to learn, what you want to study, and have a picture in your mind of what you want to achieve at the end, because obviously you're gonna struggle at some point, but bear in your mind what are your goals and what you want to really get in from that program, or from your professors, or from your peer students. So that's my advice. First of all, I've been in China for like more than 5 years, so I know actually quite well the lifestyle here in Asia. So I will say that countries that I would like to visit will be mostly in the Europe side. I'm talking about the UK, United Kingdom, or Germany, or Sweden. Those are the three countries I would like to visit in Europe. And there are other countries that I would like also to visit in other continents, like in America, I would like to visit most likely Brazil or Argentina, or the United States, why not, or Canada. And coming back to my continent, my lovely continent, Africa, obviously my country, I would like to live in my country. I'm saying that there's no other better place to live than your own country. So my country will be best for me to live in. And I would also like to visit other countries in Africa, because I only visited like two countries in Africa, which are Benin and my country, my own country. So I would like to visit like other countries like South Africa or Congo or Rwanda and go around Africa and know a little bit more about where I'm from. Okay, I intend for us to graduate from Tsinghua University, which is, like we know, it's one of the best universities in China and even in the world. So I guess that Tsinghua University will open the doors for me for careers and opportunities elsewhere. So I'm intending probably to pursue a PhD or work in some kind of have some working experiences first and doing my PhD afterwards. This is something I'm considering, but the idea also is to come back to my country and contribute to the development of the society and the economy in general. I have a dream that we can even build a Silicon Valley in our countries in Africa. Why not? That's a dream that I have. And in my area, which is aviation and aerospace engineering, I'm thinking even like having what about a space center? What about doing something related to aerospace? I believe that the next stage of human evolution will be space exploration. So I believe that Africa will play a key role in that area. In conclusion, I would like to thank Elson for his time, come here and to visit me and to ask me questions about my life here, my studies, my experiences. So I'm actually thankful for that. And I would like also to ask you guys to subscribe to his channel. He has good content. And why not subscribe to my channel, because I'm also doing something, but it's most likely related to music and stuff. I'm playing the keyboard. Thank you guys, and I hope that my experiences will benefit you as well.